Welcome to our latest Wandering Walks of Wonder tour. This time we're headed to the Country Club Plaza in Kansas City to take a look at a number of Easter statues. This is an annual tradition on the Country Club Plaza. The most famous of all the statues that you see along the Country Club Plaza are these bunnies, which have been a part of the plaza's springtime tradition since 1931. The bunnies are named Amy, Bess, Brian, Ellen, Kate, Lee, Nicholas, Peter, and Sue, and they are joined by 8 other animals that we'll see along the walk today. You'll see turtles, swans, and pelicans. It's a great way to get into the Easter spirit. As we go around and search for the bunny statues here on the Country Club Plaza, it's a little bit about the history of this area in Kansas City. The Country Club Plaza, it's a privately owned regional shopping center. It was opened in 1923 and was the first planned suburban shopping center and the first regional shopping center to accommodate shoppers arriving by car in the United States. The plaza is an outdoor museum of romantic Spanish architecture and European art where people live and work every day amongst its beauty. It's home to over 120 shops and dozens of fine restaurants and is a popular tourist attraction or destination in Kansas City. The plaza hosts a number of events and festivals throughout the year, including the annual Plaza Art Fair. And at Christmas time, starting on Thanksgiving night, the plaza lighting ceremony. I have several videos of the lights on the plaza. If you want to take a look at those videos, just look for them, and you'll see what this area looks like at night during Christmas time.
Thank you.
The Country Club Plaza was named for the Country Club District, which is this area of Kansas City. It was an area or neighborhood developed by J.C. Nichols, which surrounded the Kansas City Country Club. Nichols began acquiring the land for the plaza in 1907 in an area of Kansas City that was then known as Brush Creek Valley. When his plans were first announced, the project was dubbed Nichols Folly because of the then seemingly undesirable location. At the time, the only developed land in the valley belonged to the Country Day School, which is now called the Pembroke Hill School, and the rest of this area was known for its pig farming. Nichols employed architect Edward Delk to design the new shopping district. The plaza opened in 1923 to immediate success and has lasted with little interruption since that year. Here we see a few more of the bunny statues that are placed on the plaza during the springtime, just about a month before Easter begins. For its first four decades, the plaza combined some higher-end shops, such as the famous Harsfell department store, with a mix of more mid-level retailers such as Sears and Woolworths. There are a number of different types of establishments in the plaza area when it first opened, including a bowling alley, a movie store, and a grocery store to serve the daily needs of residents of the district. Starting around 1970, many high-end hotel luxury hotels started popping up in the plaza area, including the Ritz-Carlton Hotel and several others. Also, some of the more higher-end stores and upscale retailers started coming into the plaza, including Gucci, Polo, Ralph Lauren, FAO Schwarz, and at one time a Saks Fifth Avenue. Today, the plaza still includes a number of higher-end stores, as well as unique-to-market stores, including Tiffany & Company, Michael Kors, Kate Spade, Indochina, Free People, Tommy Bahama, and Vineyard Vines. One of the most significant events on the plaza occurred in September of 1977, when there was a major flood along Brush Creek that caused severe damage to the plaza and resulted in a number of deaths. The flood prompted a vast renovation and revitalization of the area that has not only allowed it to survive, but to thrive. The architecture in the plaza area is really unique, not only to Kansas City, but to the rest of the United States. The basic design of the Country Club Plaza reflects classic European influences, especially those of Seville, Spain. And one thing you would notice as you walk along is there's not a traditional open plaza like you find in many European cities. Along the way, there are more than 30 statues, murals, and tile mosaics on display in the area, making this a walking art display as well. The tallest building that we just saw a few minutes ago is a half-size representation of the Giralda Tower of Seville, and it's the tallest building on the plaza. The plaza also includes reproductions of San Francisco's Path of Gold streetlights, and again, you can see many classical works of art, including this fountain that we see here, other statues, tile work. Although the plaza was designed and built to accommodate visitors arriving by automobile, it's unlike modern shopping malls with sprawling parking lots. Parking is concealed in multi-level parking garages beneath and behind the shops or on the rooftops of the buildings. Another unique feature that occurred with the creation of the plaza in 1923 was it was the first shopping center to use the percentage lease, where rents are based on a percentage of the gross receipts of tenants. This was a novel idea when Nichols invented it, but it's now a standard practice in many commercial leases across the United States. In 1925, a single strand of 16-colored lights was placed above a doorway in the Country Club Plaza to celebrate Christmas. The number of lights increased annually, inspiring an official lighting ceremony that took place in 1930. On Thanksgiving night, tens of thousands of people come down to the plaza for local entertainment and to watch the switch throwing to initiate the Christmas season. A special guest or celebrity often flips the switch each year. The Plaza Season of Lights is one of the city's oldest traditions. The lights are turned on Thanksgiving evening and shine overnight through roughly about mid-January.
Like there was one that was literally...
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I hope you've enjoyed this tour of Easter time on the Country Club Plaza in Kansas City. Make sure to like and subscribe to this video. We'll see you on the next one. Take care. Bye.